close to $4 a gallon. Half the country is living paycheck to paycheck, and everything at the supermarket is way too expensive. But President Biden today stood in front of the country and said, "You're welcome."
Bidenomics is just another way of saying restoring the American dream.
Do you think it's any easier to achieve the American dream today than it was a couple of years ago? Of course not, because the Inflation Reduction Act was never supposed to reduce inflation. It was a Trojan horse for the climate change crowd. The only people it helped are Biden's donors who work in green energy. You see, it was all a lie. And what do you do when you get caught in a lie? You lie more.
No one making less than $400,000 a year will pay a single penny more in federal taxes. It's a commitment I've kept so far, and as long as I'm president, I will keep it.
Wrong. Working class families had their tax burden jacked up. Who do you think is paying for all the windmills? You. And Biden proudly says he cut our national debt.
We actually cut the federal debt, the deficit, by $1.7 trillion. Hear me? The first 2 years, we cut the debt by $1.7 trillion.
Wrong again. Our national debt went up almost $4 trillion since Biden took office. At least your energy bill went down, right?
This law is helping families save thousands of dollars on energy bills every year through the tax credit and rebates to buy new and efficient electric appliances, weatherize their homes, install heat pumps, rooftop solar.
Another lie. You're paying more to heat your house and power your AC. Now, unless you want to spend $30,000 sticking solar panels on your roof, this bill doesn't help you at all. But Joe Biden thinks he's the most successful president in American history.
Name me a single objective we've ever set out to accomplish that we've failed on. Name me one.
Okay, Joe, you've failed on reducing inflation, lowering gas prices, securing the border, and withdrawing from Afghanistan, to name just a few. Joe Biden has been lying his entire career. Now, the first time Biden ran for president back in 1988, he said he graduated at the top of his class.
I have a much higher IQ than you do, I suspect. I went to law school on a full academic scholarship, the only one in my class to have a full academic scholarship. In the first year in law school, I decided I didn't want to be in law school, and then decided I wanted to stay, went back to law school, and in fact ended up in the top half of my class.
And back then, though, the media actually fact-checked Democrats.
Biden now concedes he did not graduate in the top half of his law school class, that he does not have 3 degrees from college, and that he was not named outstanding political science student in college.
Newsweek says Biden actually went to school on a half scholarship, ended up near the bottom of his class, and won only 1 degree, not 3.
Joe Biden ranked 76th in a class of 85 at the University of Syracuse Law School.
So Joe eventually had to drop out, not for lying about his grades, but for plagiarizing someone else.
Why is it that my wife, who's sitting out there in the audience, is the first in her family to ever go to college?
Why is Gladys the first woman in her family in 1,000 generations to be able to get the university?
They didn't have a platform upon which to stand.
There was no platform upon which they could stand.
Biden never learned his lesson. He said he used to drive 18-wheelers. He never did. He said he was arrested while marching for civil rights. That never happened. He said he was against the Afghanistan war from the beginning. But he voted for it in 2001. And that's not all.
If you're vaccinated, you're not going to be hospitalized, you're not going to be in an ICU unit, and you're not going to die.
We know that's not true. But Biden's biggest lie of all is this.
I did not know he was on the board of that company.
I've never discussed my business or their business, my sons or daughters.
I never discussed a single thing with my son about anything having to do with Ukraine.
I've never spoken to my son about his overseas business dealings.
I have never discussed with my son or my brother or anyone else anything having to do with their businesses, period.
Joe never discussed business with his son. He just talked to his son Hunter's business partners on speakerphone. He went golfing with them, too, and went to birthday dinners with Burisma executives, Russian billionaires, and Kazakhstan businessmen. Here's the truth. This guy has been lying since the day he stepped into Washington. He has lied his way all the way to the top. But now he's been caught red-handed, and we're not going to let him get away with it anymore.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.
Join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MCAD TV family. Please like and share MCAD TV. We love you all. Please support MCAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.